glory to your God, glory to you, Heavenly King, Comforter, Spirit of Truth, present in all places and filling all things, the treasury of blessings and giver of life, come and abide in us, cleanse us of every stain, and save our souls to good will.
Amen. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. All holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, be gracious to us in our sins. Master, forgive our transgressions, Holy One, consider our weaknesses, and heal them for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
That is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Protect your people and bless your inheritance, granting victory to the faithful over adversaries, and protect your commonwealth by your cross. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lift up on the cross by your free will, Christ God, grant mercy to the commonwealth that bears your name. Let our faithful rulers by your power give you the victory over your adversaries, bring your life to you within our weapon for peace and invisible standard. Now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Awesome and unfailing protection, unite us for our supplications, gracious and all praises to the Father. Uphold the Orthodox commonwealth, preserve those who have called together, and grant them victory from on high. For you, the only blessed one, give mercy to God.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Better than life itself, and there shall be greater praise. I shall bless you as long as I live. you throughout your watches, that you be taken to me that offer my name to shout for your means that will find the way. My soul cleanses you in your right hand. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always, and forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always, and forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, God of my salvation, day and night I cry out to before you. Let my prayer reach up to you and enter into my plea, O Lord. For my soul is filled with trouble, and my life came close to Hades. I was darkened with those who go down to the pit, and I was like a man beyond help, left for dead. Like the slain one of the lions, the great ghost, you remember no more, for they are cut away from your hand. You cast me down to the deepest of distance, darkness, and the shadow of death. Carrying me with a burden upon you, for the door was open, and you took my friends away from me, and made me close to the dead. I was closed in and could not escape my house, for dealing with distress. I cried out to you, Lord, on the day I stretched out my hands to you. But when you were plundered to the dead, or in physician, pray to God to see your praise. Does anyone see your love in the grave, or your truthfulness in the midst of perdition? Are your marvels ever known in darkness, or your justice in the land of the living? And yet, O Lord, I cried out to you, and to you my prayer shall rise at dawn. Why, O Lord, do you reject my prayer? Why do you have your face away from me? I am wretched and troubled since my youth. I was raised high and humbled in distress. Your plagues have swept over me, and your terrors have left me shaken. And surrounded by waters of the day, they both are upon me from all sides. You distance from me, and friend and neighbor, and my acquaintances, so wretched am I. O Lord God, my salvation, day and night, I pray that before you. Let my prayer reach up to you and enter into my request, O Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul, may all that is in me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all the gifts from him. Who pardons all your sins and heals all your infirmities. Who asks that you like from corruption and crowns with his love and mercies. Who fills your longing with what is good and your youth is renewed like the eagles. The Lord performs deeds of kindness and vindication for all the oppressed. He has made known his ways to Moses and his will to his children. The Lord is the God of compassion and mercy, long suffering, and manifold love. His compassion is not forever, nor will his anger always last. He has not dealt with us as our sins demand, nor does he repay our evil deeds. For as high as I have been standing in the earth, so far as the Lord extended his help to those. For as far as the east is from the west, so far as he removed our sins from us. As kind as the Father is to his children, so is the Lord to those who fear him. For he himself knows well how your form remembers where it only made dust. Amen. His days are still oppressed, and the fire is built to shut him loose. And by the free Passover evening, and he is gone, never shall he know his place again. If the love of the Lord is from my turning to my turning to those who fear him, and his justice upon the children of children of those who keep his covenant and remember his gospel of Abraham. The Lord has established his throne in heaven, and for all things his kingship is decreed. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, his strong and mighty ones who obey his word on hearing the sound of his decree. Bless the Lord, all you his prophets, his attendants who obey his will. Bless the Lord, all you his courts, and every place of his dominion. Bless the Lord, my soul. Bless the Lord, my soul, and every place of his dominion. The Lord, hear my prayer, your truthfulness and peace, my plea, and your righteousness answer me. And in an honest judgment with your servants, and with all living man is just in your sight. The enemy has not put me down, he has crushed my life into the ground, and has forced me to live in darkness like those long dead. My spirit faints with grief, and within me my heart is in despair. I recall the days of old, I meditated on my remains, upon the works of your hands. I stretched out my hand to you with a parched land, my soul thirsts for you. May face the answer me, Lord, my spirit has failed me. Turn not your face away from me, lest I be like those in the pit. Grant that I may hear your steadfast love of God, for I have placed my hope in you. O Lord, teach me the way I should go, for I have lifted up myself to you. O Lord, deliver me from my enemies, and it is to you that I have fled. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. May your good spirit lead me on a straight path. For the sake of your name, O Lord, you will keep me alive. In your righteousness, you will deliver me from affliction, and in your loving kindness, you will destroy my enemies. And bring to naught all those who oppress me, for I am your servant. O Lord, hear my prayer, and your truthfulness be deep in my plan, and your righteousness answer me. May your good
Hades, and Hades liberated everyone. Let us then argue, O Lord, teach me your statutes. Why do you mingle the ointments with your tears? Look in your women disciples. Thus the angel who was shining in the tomb cried to the myrrh-bearing
Christ would also cut their neck with the
mental or very women and gave them joy instead of sorrow. And your apostles, you informed of the symbols of victory. My life-giving Savior, you illumined creation, O lover of man. Therefore, the world also rejoices for your rising from the dead, O most merciful.
O most merciful.
On August the 2nd, we commemorate the recovery of the relic of St. Stephen, the proto martyr of Archdeacon and Archdeacon. On this day, we also commemorate the finding of the relics of the holy martyrs Maximus, Dudus, and Quintilian. On this day, we also commemorate the consecration of the Holy Church of St. John the Theologian, apostle and evangelist near the most holy great church. On this day, we commemorate the holy martyrs Phocas and also Emperor Justinian, of pious memory in the church of the holy apostle. Confession of your saints and God have mercy on us and save us. Amen.
The evening of that day, the first day of the week, the doors being shut where the disciples were for fear of the Jews. aside. Then the disciples were glad that they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, even so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you remit the sins of any, they are remitted. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." Now Thomas, one of the 12 called the twin, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he had said to them, "Unless I see in his hands the print of the nails, and place my finger in the mark of the nails, and place my hand in his side, I will not believe." 8 days later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. The doors were shut, but Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see in my hands, and put out your hand and place it in my side. Do not be faithless, but believing." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of the disciples, which are now written in this book. But these are written that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing you may have life. Sarah, Sarah, the wonder workers of the Holy Glorious Great Martyr. commemorate today and of all the saints, we beseech you, O merciful Lord, hear us, and as we pray, to have mercy upon us.
Thank you.
sing to the heavens, and he saw the divine glory as much as he was Jesus, Savior of our souls. should have closed our doors. It was nice to have everyone in church. It was a good thing. The reason that I've not gone straight and directly into the divine liturgy is because, in addition to everyone else that we are praying for during this time, just over the weekend, I received an email asking for prayers for Deacon Epipedes Christolides. That is the brother of George Panagis. He has a disease that's attacking his red blood cells based on a bite from an insect. He is in the ICU. He is struggling. So Epipedes the deacon is the prayers. When we are praying for the divine liturgy, of course today is 40 days for Bill McElhaney, so keep that in mind as well in the prayers. So we should keep these people in mind as we're praying for the divine liturgy. Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above, the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Archbishop and Father, Savas, the honorable presbyters, the deacons in the service of Christ, of the clergy, the laity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our country, the president, and all those in public service, and for the armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this parish and city, for every city and country, and for the faithful who live in them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the favorable weather and abundance of the fruits of the earth and peaceful seasons, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For travelers by land, sea, and air, for the sick, the suffering, the captives, and for passi por mim, Lord, so grande e esboja que é de maldade.
Lord, have mercy.
Nas que a gente perdiste em preso, lá no seu e no eslavo, no barulho, em ginásio, no barulho, em ginásio, no barulho, em ginásio, no barulho, entreat him to save our souls. mind, they may understand that your passion was deliberate and declared to the world that in truth you are the Father's radiance. Let us pray to the Lord.
Said, Brethren and fathers, hear me. The God of glory appeared to our father Abraham when he was in Mesopotamia, before he lived in Haran, and said to him, Depart from your land and from your kindred, and go into the land which I will show you. Then he departed from the land of the Chaldeans and lived in Haran. And after his father died, God removed him from there into this land in which you are now living. Yet he gave him no inheritance in it, not even a foot's length, but promised to give it to him in possession and to his posterity after him, though he had no child. But it was Solomon who built a house for him. Yet the Most High did not dwell in houses made with hands. As the prophet says, Heaven is my throne and the earth my footstool. What house will you build for me, says the Lord? And what is this place, the place of my rest? Did not my hand make all these things? And you stiff-necked people, uncircumcised in heart and ears, you always resist the Holy Spirit, as your fathers did, so do you, which the prophets did not your fathers persecute, and they killed those who announced before the coming of the Righteous One, whom you have now betrayed and murdered, you who received the law as delivered by the angels and did not keep it. Now when they heard these things, they were enraged, and they ground their teeth against him. But he, full of the Holy Spirit, gazed into heaven and saw the glory of God, and Jesus standing at the right hand of God, and he said, Behold, I see the heavens open, and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God. But they cried out with a loud voice, and stopped their ears, and rushed together upon him. Then they cast him out of the city, and stoned him. And the witnesses laid down their garments at the feet of a young man named Saul. And as they were stoning Stephen, he prayed, Lord Jesus, receive my spirit. And he knelt down and cried with a loud voice, Lord, do not hold this sin against them. And when he said this, he fell asleep.
In his heat, the light was for me, easy to do the return.
Τους μαθητές αυτού εμπίνε εις τον πλοίο του.
Deus Daniel Manis Monos in Eki, to the Pion E. the Master Pistala Sassi, Kevasanizomen on E. Poton Primaton, Ilegar and Dios Oenemos, Kedati the Philatikis Victos of Eden Proslavus is Joisius Peripaton Epitis Talasas, Ke. Και οι δόντες αυτών, οι μαθητές επί τη θάλασσα, περιπατούνται εκ τα τεράκτησα λέγοντες ότι φάντισμα έστει και από του φόβου έκραξαν. Ευθέως δεν ελάλησαν αυτοίς ο Ιησούς λέγον, θα σείτε εγώ ημί, μη φοβήστε. Αποκριθήστε αυτό η Πέτρος είπε, Κύριε Ιησύ, κέλεσον με προς σε ερθήν επί τα ύδατα, ο δε είπεν ερθέ, και κατά βάς από του πλοίον ο Πέτρος περιεπάτησαν επί την ύδατη ερθήν προς τον Ιησού. Βλέπον δε το ένεμον ισχυρόν εφοβήθη, και αξάμενος κατακουντήσεστε έκραξα λέγω, Κύριε σώσον με. Ευθέως δε ο Ιησούς εκτείνα στην χείρα επιλάβε το αυτού και λέγει αυτό, ο λιγόπιστε εις τη αντίστασας και εμβάντων αυτών εις τον πλοίον εκόπασεν ο έμεμος. Ο δε εν το πλοίο ερχόντες προσεκίνησαν αυτόν λέγοντες, αληθώς Θεού Υιός και διαπεράσαντες ηρθόν εις την γενή and go before him to the other side while he dismissed the crowds. And after he had dismissed the crowds, he went up into the hills by himself to pray. When evening came, he was there alone. But the boat by this time was many furlongs distant from the land, beaten by the waves, for the wind was against them. And in the fourth watch of the night, he came to them, walking on the sea. But when the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified, saying, It is a ghost! And they cried out for fear. But immediately he spoke to them, saying, Take heart, it is I, have no fear. And Peter answered him, Lord, if it is you, bid me to come to you on the water. He said, Come. So Peter got out of the boat and walked on the water and came to Jesus. But when he saw the wind, he was afraid, and beginning to sink, he cried out, Lord, save me. Jesus immediately reached out his hand and caught him, saying to him, O man of little faith, why did you doubt? And when they entered the boat, the wind ceased, and those in the boat worshipped him, saying, Truly you are the Son of God.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I know what I'm doing. Woke you up. I know what I'm doing. It's a sentence that used to come out of my mouth a lot when I was younger. Telling my parents whenever I would want to do something that was a little dangerous. Don't worry, Dad. Don't worry, Mom. I know what I'm doing. You know, and then I'd find myself in a very precarious situation about the fall, about the this. Of course, as soon as that would happen, I'd be asking them for help, trying to bail me out of whatever situation I happen to find myself in. And whether it's, you know, whether it's in your spending money when you're younger or even when you're older, whether you're driving on the road and somebody's in the car telling you, yeah, hey, don't go this way, you should go this way or go that way. No, I know what I'm doing, the GPS says this or, you know, whatever. We find ourselves in very interesting situations in our lives. And many times when we find ourselves in those situations, we have gotten there of our own devices, by our own stubbornness, by our own, I should say, reluctance to listen to those around us and the people that are telling us, hey, you know, maybe you should do it this way. I can tell you just in my own life that everyone else in the world was telling me to be a priest, and I kept trying to explain to them, no. It's not what I'm going to be in my life. It's not what I'm going to do. My parents, my priest, my presbytera, the people in my high school, my nickname was Padre. Everyone else was telling me I knew. They knew that this is what I was going to do. No, I'm going to be an electrical engineer. That's what I was going to be. My papu was an electrical engineer. Told myself that's what I was going to do. And I kept ignoring what everyone else was saying. Until I found myself, like Peter, in some pretty deep waters. In the University of Pittsburgh, I had to switch into religious studies, and God kind of made it very clear that I should be a priest and not a religious engineer. But what is the message of this gospel today, brothers and sisters in Christ? It's the message first of Lord Savior. It's the words that Peter said when he was on the water. The ones that he said as he was not God. We got to remember in this gospel, the one that was walking on the water first was Jesus, but the second person that was walking on the water was not God. He had the same flesh and blood as we have. And he did not have the 100% divinity that caused God to defy his own laws of physics. He had none of it. When we see Peter walking on the water, it's our disgusting, sinful flesh that was doing that. And of course we know, having heard this gospel our whole lives, that as long as Peter was looking at Christ, everything was good. It was when he started, for fear, looking down at the waves that he started to sink. We find ourselves often sinking. And it's not necessarily just because we've taken our gaze away from God. Although, I would say that we have taken our gaze even for a second away from the Lord, because if we were constantly focusing our attention on God, we would all be saints. We'd all have halos around our head. So we get distracted. But more than just the taking our focus from God, it's the fact that we let fear into our lives and stubbornness. And the ability to say, I know what I'm doing. I mean, it's a pretty bold request of Peter anyway to say, if it's you, come, bid me to come out to the water. I'm sure the other apostles are going, are you nuts? Peter, who the heck do you think you are? Do you think that you are the same as Christ? And for that brief moment, he possessed the same faith as Christ. It was Christ's faith. Just like it is our faith. When we walk on the waters of the unknown, when we embark on something that we're just very unsure of, we're looking for a sign, right? We're looking for something that's going to let us know that this is the way we're supposed to be walking. Doctor comes in and says, you know, we have this diagnosis, or we're struggling with this, or we're struggling with this, or we're struggling with this, or this. Not necessarily physically, but spiritually. And we're wading out on waters that we're unfamiliar with. And the waves are beating us down. Before we get to the words, Lord, save me, there's another message in this gospel. And it's the message of the mountain. Wait, hold on a second. What mountain are we talking about? There's no mountain here. Oh, yeah, there is. Look at that. After Jesus dismissed the crowd, remember last week's gospel? This is one of the few gospels where they go back to back like this from Sunday to Sunday. After he dismissed the crowds, the what crowds? The feeding of the 5,000 crowds. And he sent them home, full bellies with 12 baskets of food left over. After that was all done, he sent the apostles to the boat, he sent the crowds away, and where did he go? Right back up the mountain to pray. Why? He's God. I mean, what is he going to be? You know, when I was a child, I'm reading this gospel, I'm going, is he schizophrenic, praying to himself? What is this? And it wasn't until I was older and I got to read the fathers of the church, St. John Chrysostom specifically, in this case, he talks about the mountain. That the mountain is the mother of silence. And that only in silence can we find God. Think about it. What in our society, what in our world intrinsically has God in it? Nothing. Because it's all surrounded by noise, by distraction, by craziness, by chaos. Silence puts things into order. Stillness puts things into perspective. The mountain was the preparation, not just of Christ for the walking on the water, but the preparation for himself for whatever was going to come next in his life. Before we can get to the Lord save me moment the way we have in this gospel, we've got to find stillness in our lives. We've got to have silence in our lives. And, you know, I'm sure you're talking, okay, Father, end the sermon, just go back up, silence. But no! It's not just stop talking, silence. Because we can stop talking and we're still, our head's going crazy. Try it, if you have not already. Try to find stillness in your soul. Honestly. Go home after church today. It's probably going to be the easiest for you to do after church today. Go home and spend 2.5 minutes. Don't even look at the clock. Just set a stopwatch or a countdown timer on your phone, whatever. Good. 2 minutes. You'll be antsy after one if you're not already practicing stillness. Because needs to be done over here. What needs to be going, oh my goodness, and I have this appointment tomorrow, and I've got this thing going on. Oh, and my goodness, that's loud. What is that noise from my neighbor? What's going on? You know, this is just what we have. It's hard to find silence. It's hard to find stillness. But we need it. So Jesus, after finding that stillness, after finding that silence, after showing his disciples what exactly he needed to do for his relationship with the Father and what we need to do with our relationship with the Father, calls Peter out, and there's that Lord save me moment. Why? Because sometimes even with our silence, our stillness, our prayer, our fasting, our almsgiving, we still find ourselves. We still find ourselves doubting. We still find ourselves lacking just a bit of faith. The faith needed for this day's daily bread. And when we find that moment, we have another net. We've got another net. It's the same net that caught the apostles. It's the same net that the apostles used to catch more people. It's Christ. It's the church. That's what the boat is. The boat, according to the fathers of the church, is the church. And it is our job to get in it the way we are today and the way we will have that opportunity for the remainder of the 15 days of August. Church four times, if not more, a week. It's our opportunity to get the boat. It's our opportunity to find, even though we venture outside that boat throughout our lives and we find ourselves beaten by the waves, it's our opportunity to get back inside where there is stillness. Because think about that. Why didn't Jesus calm the storm before he got into the boat? It was only when they were together, completely and totally together, that he calmed the storm. It's when he got in the boat that the storm ceased. In another story, when he was in the boat and he was sleeping and they woke him up, then the storm ceased again. It's when they were together in the boat of learning that the waters and the raging waves of our lives will cease from beating us down. Peter had his Lord save me moment in the gospel. We have our sometimes every single day of our lives. And that's okay. The trick is not to get ourselves into the position where we're saying, "That's okay, God, I know what I'm doing." But rather, follow where he's leading us. And we still might find ourselves struggling. That's okay. But if we're struggling under the obedience of our Lord, if we're struggling under the obedience of the church, if we're struggling under the obedience of the fathers and the saints, like Saint Stephen, who was stoned for being a believer of Christ, then at least we're not beaten by our own stubbornness. At least we're not beaten by our own obstinacy. At least we're not beaten by our own pride. And God's help at that moment will be a salvific help, not a chastising. When he says to Peter, as he's lifting him up, "Oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt?" He's talking to us. We are beaten by the waves of our lives and our decision to Christ. But with God's help, with our stillness, with our silence, with getting in the boat, and everything else that we are doing during these times, it is not needlessly. There is an end to our suffering and struggle. They may not be while we're alive, but there is an end. And there's relief along the way. God gives us little moments of rest. This time is the time for the stillness and the silence to boost ourselves so that when the waves do hit us and we call out to the Lord, Lord, save me, he will lift us up. Not till the next time that we're stubborn, but till the next time when we call upon him with great faith and with love, and he lifts us up permanently into the kingdom of his heaven. Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please rise and we'll continue the divine liturgy. Again and again, peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Amen.
save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
With all of you.
Amen.
to the Lord. By the grace, mercy, and love for us of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, Together with your all holy and life-giving spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Also visibly present among us, come and sanctify us. And let your pure body and precious blood be given to us by your mighty hand, and for us by your people. Let us be attentive to the holy gifts for the holy people of God.
Thank you. Thank you.
always, now, and forever, to the ages of ages.
Oh.
morning. Good to see all of your wonderful and smiling faces. Wonderful to be back from our African safari. It was nice. The lions were gentle, but the giraffes, you know, it was crazy. No, I'm joking. We have a good week this week coming. It has been a year since we've entered the 15 days of August, of course, and we are now on the second day of that 15-day period. We are in the process of going through the extra practice services that will be happening not just on Wednesdays, they will be happening. One of these days you're going to get brave enough to talk to you. One of these days. You can say different. You see the threat, though. Monday, Wednesday, Friday. There will be services every night. Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Every Monday, Wednesday, Friday. Weeks. Most of those services will be paraklesi services. But for this coming... For this coming Wednesday and the following Friday, they will be. Oh, see, there you go. There you go.
Thank you.
Welcome back to the choir that was singing as a choir with Moses and stuff. God bless you, Mr.